Hi guys, welcome back. Okay, so how do I word this? 2020 is going to be a little bit different in regards to my channel. I'm still figuring some things out, what I want to do, what I don't want to do, but I definitely want to get more acquainted with my current makeup collection. I have a lot of makeup. And it's not to say that I feel like, oh my gosh, I have way too much makeup, because I have a YouTube channel. So I do try a lot of things out and talk to you guys about them. But I have a lot of makeup and I really want to start loving on the makeup I have. So with that being said, I plan on at least trying to buy a lot less makeup in the upcoming year. So for 2020, I definitely would never say I'm going on a no buy, but I really am going to try to cut back on a lot of my makeup purchases, especially, I mean, the hardest thing for me is eyeshadow palettes. First and foremost, eyeshadow palettes are like my weakness, okay? But as I'm getting more familiar with my taste, with certain brands that I really like, certain color schemes that I like, it's becoming a bit easier for me to look at a palette and say, yes, I've got to have it, and look at a palette and say, oh, that's cute, but I really don't need it. Whereas the last couple of years, it's been like, oh, that's cute, I'm buying it. Oh, that's bomb, I'm buying it. Oh, I want to try it, I'm buying it. And I don't want to do that anymore because, for one, I'm running out of space, and for two, I don't need all that stuff. I'm buying a lot of stuff over and over again, the same shades, the same colors, and it's getting repetitive for me. So I really want to start loving on the makeup I have. And in doing so, I'm just kind of going through my stuff, and while I'm decluttering, I'm actually like, oh, that's really nice. Okay, that's really bomb. Let me use this for a week or two and see what's happening. So that's what's going on with me right now. I'm just kind of like exploring my collection, getting more familiar with what I have, and trying to resist buying a lot of things that I just really don't need. I mean, I bought so many backups last year, whether it was concealer, mascara, eyeliners, foundation. It's like certain things that I bought backups of, I still haven't finished the first one that I've been working on because I try so much makeup. So 2020 for me is going to be a year of trying to use up some of my makeup. I don't plan on buying any new foundation. I don't care what it is, how bomb it looks. I'm really going to try not to buy any new foundation. I'm not buying any more mascara. I'm not buying any more eyeliner. I'm not buying any more highlighters, blushes, stuff like that I have a lot of already. I have a nice range of shades and colors and stuff to play around in. I'm really going to fight the urge, okay? Y'all don't come for me if I happen to, you know, a certain highlighter comes out and it's just amazing and I fall, okay? I'm going to try. I'm not saying that I'm going to be successful, but I'm going to really, really try. But yeah, and this video, I'm sure it might go up before my Black Friday haul, because look, Black Friday really turned into Black November 24th through December. It's still going on, okay? So Black Friday has just been ridiculous, and I did go a little crazy. I did purchase some new palettes, some new highlighters, some new lipsticks, just because everything was on sale. So yes, I did buy some things, but after that haul, after, you know, the start of the new year and all these sales and stuff are over with, I'm going to be done for a while. I put my Ipsy on hold. I still currently have BoxyCharm. I haven't got my box, but I'm waiting for it right now. But I still currently have BoxyCharm, but I put Ipsy on hold, you know, after that whole debacle and stuff with the Ipsy Ultimate. I was just like, you know, let me pump my brakes. I have so much skincare that it's ridiculous. And I need to chill. Just for my own sanity, I need to chill. But that does not mean that I'm going to not have content for you guys, that I'm not going to have me trying new products and stuff, because like I said, I'm not going to no buy, just a low buy. So I will still do the occasional purchase of something that I absolutely have to have. An example of something like that is the Melt Muerte and what is it? Vida and Muerte palettes. Those I had to have. Period. Okay. I don't care what was happening, I was buying those. So that's just an example of something that I would say, okay, I'm buying it. This is the one thing that I really, really have to have this month. So anyway, with all that being said, I guess this is going to be a combination video talking about my plans for my channel in 2020 and swatching highlighters, because I really just sat down to swatch some highlighters with you guys, because I was looking at my highlighter collection, and although in my mind I didn't have a lot of highlighters, I actually do. And as I started taking a look at them, I was like, ooh, you know what? If somebody is out there looking for a new highlighter, or maybe they're having a difficult time finding you know, one that works for their skin tone, if they're the same skin tone as me, maybe they can see something in my collection that they want to get. So I know I'm doing a lot of talking in the intro of this video, and I'm not really feeling that bad about it, just because of the fact that I really did want to kind of address some things that I do want to change for my channel next year. I actually want to get back into my fitness. I was really going hard like a couple of years ago with weight loss and stuff, and I was documenting it here on YouTube, and I fell off, so I just kind of stopped documenting it and stuff. And I really want to get back into that, because I want to do some other things on my channel, not just makeup and beauty and stuff like that. I also want to do like fashion try on hauls and stuff like that, but in order for me to do that, I have to be 100% comfortable with my body, my size, and how I feel about how I look in certain things. So with that being a goal of mine, hopefully I will be able to push myself to get back on track with my fitness and stuff, so I can bring to you guys some additional kind of lifestyle things, you know. So I don't know, I might do some vlogs, I might do a few more things with my husband, who knows. But yeah, those are just some things that I really want to kind of focus on in the upcoming year. And you know, don't fear, my channel is not going to completely change. I will always do makeup looks. I will always talk about new products. I will always try eyeshadow palettes. But I want to venture off into some new things. So anyways, with all of that being said, let's go ahead and take a look at some of these highlighters, y'all, okay? So I'm just going to just kind of show you the highlighters that I have in my collection. I don't really see myself doing a declutter right now, because everything I'm looking at, I actually want to keep. So let's just go ahead and take a look at some of these highlighters and get to swatching, okay? Now, this is one I've had for quite a while. This is from Beauty Creations. Very, very affordable brand. This is their Angel Glow Quad of highlighters. And I was really pretty impressed by these highlighters when I first used them, first started my YouTube channel. So it does kind of have a little bit of, you know, a special meaning in my collection, because this might have been the first highlighter quad that I bought for my channel. But let me just swatch some of these for you guys. They're not, you know, at this point, any of my favorite highlighters by far, you know. But if you're looking for an affordable highlighter quad, let me swatch this last one too. Yeah, if you're looking for an affordable highlighter quad and you have a little bit lighter skin tone, because these are a bit light for me, this is the one that I would always use. It's the darkest one, which is really, really pretty. But if you have a lighter skin tone, then this is not bad for like a starter highlighter quad, because it's only like $6 on Amazon. So not bad. And some of the highlighters that I have are actually like part of contour and blush palettes. So, you know, you'll get the blush, the contour, the highlighter, and stuff like that. So, I don't know if I'm going to go through all of those, but I do have some of those as well. Now, this is the Huda Beauty 3D Highlighter Palette. I've used this several times on my channel as well. I know you guys are familiar with this one. It is so, so pretty. I mean, this highlighter quad is gorgeous. And it has like different creams and powders in here. So it's kind of like you can do like layering, or, you know, you can use them individually, but you can use them layered or in different places on your face. So let me go ahead and swatch this quad as well. But these highlighters are so, so pretty. And they have really nice tones for women of color in here, quite honestly. I think that there are two different ones that she has. Y'all know I can't see that well. This one, Bronze Sands Edition. So this one that I have is the Bronze Sands Edition. And I love these highlighters. They're so pretty, creamy. They look gorgeous on my skin tone. And like I said, you can use them in different ways. Okay, next I have this highlighter palette. This was a Morphe collab with, what's the guy's name? Bretman Rock, I think. Yeah. So this is the Babe in Paradise highlighter palette. And I always forget about this palette, so I never ever use it. I always forget about this palette, but there are some really nice highlighters in here as well. These have a little bit more of kind of like a soft feel to them. So those are some of the lighter shades. And I'm not even sure. I wonder if they still sell this since it was a collab. I'm not sure. But these are two of the darker shades. Very, very pretty. And so with this palette, it's like a lot of different skin tones can use it. You know, this one, of course, is the one I would gravitate to being darker. But a lot of these can cater to several different skin tones. If I wanted something a little bit lighter, I could go with one of these as well because they're a little bit gold. So very pretty. Okay, next up, this is one that is part of a blush, highlighter, and contour set. This is the new Patricia Bright set. Her face palette that she came out with, Revolution. And the one that I have is Dusk Till Dawn. So this is the deepest, darkest set here. So let me just go ahead and swatch this highlighter. This highlighter is really pretty, you guys. It really is. It's a gorgeous gold. Very, very pretty. And not too expensive either. I believe they have these on the Ulta website now. At first it was just on Revolution, but yeah, this is a really pretty highlight. Now this one I always forget about that I have in my collection. This is in my Black Radiance contour kit, medium to dark, but this is the cream kit. Now the one that I tend to gravitate to all the time is the powder, because whenever I do decide to do a contour, I like to use powder. But this is the cream kit, so it's just like the powder. It has the contour and the sculpting and the highlight, but they're all creams. So this is what it looks like. If you do like cream, contour, and highlighting products, this one is really nice. And I have got to get some use out of this highlighter this year. Oh my gosh, do you guys see that? Do you see that? That is so pretty. Just that beautiful bronzy gold. Oh my gosh, that color is so gorgeous. And I always forget all about it. And I have it right here. So I'm definitely going to put this with my other highlighters and make sure that I use it. Next, I have here one that I gravitate to quite often because it's very easy to use. This Revolution Pro Supreme Highlighter Trio. And I've had this one for a few months now, so not too long, but I love the different shades in here. Of course, I always gravitate to this one, but let me go ahead and swatch this for you. you know, Revolution, they're hit and miss with their palettes most times, but it's like for some reason they do highlighters right. Okay, so these are the highlighters in this trio. Very, very pretty, catering to different skin tones. But yeah, of course, this darkest one here is the one that I lean towards. But honey, look at that shimmer, okay? Yeah, so this one is called the Supreme Highlighter Metal. Now, this little trio here, I got in my BoxyCharm, I think, a long time ago. It's from Pure. It's called Bronze and Brighten. I never was drawn to this just because of the fact that it's like, the color selection that they picked for this, it was just like, okay. You know, I don't use shimmery blushes. This is like super duper beaming, so I would only use it for an inner corner highlight on my eyes. And this one is really pretty, but it's very dark. So let me just swatch this for you just in case it's something that appeals to you. But yeah, this is the Bronze and Brighten Dreamer palette from Pure, and this one might actually get decluttered because, like I said, I believe I got it in my BoxyCharm quite a while ago. But yeah, it's like if you like shimmery blushes, this is it's a pretty shade, and this as a highlighter would work for me. But this is definitely something that I would just use on my eyes, not on my face. Next, I have here a Wet n Wild highlighter. I have several of these. I didn't dig them all out, but I brought this one out because this one I think is the most wearable for me. It is the Crown of My Canopy. You know, Wet n Wild, they're good for so many different highlighters. But this is what this one looks like. So let me go ahead and swatch it for you guys. Oh, it's so pretty. It has kind of like a peachy tone to it, so, but it's not too bright, you know what I mean? Like, it's really pretty and it looks gorgeous when you blend it out. See, it blends out very nicely, but it's really pretty. It's a nice soft peachy highlight. Very, very pretty. I don't know why I'm doing this, you guys, just to give you an idea of how it would look on my face. If you're like, why is she holding it next to her cheek? She's not putting it on, okay? Hello. I have highlighter on already, of course. I have, this is the Becca, is it the Champagne Pop, I think? Yeah, I have on my Becca Champagne Pop. Now, this here is the Revolution and Roxy Roxasaurus Contour and Highlight Palette. I bought, look at that reflection, gee whiz. I bought this a few months ago. I never use it. And the reason why I never use it, I don't know. I really need to, actually. Because I did use it and I was like, oh, this is actually pretty nice as a contour for me. So, yeah, I need to use this more. But let me go ahead and swatch some of these highlighters in here. Because there are a couple of highlighters. Not as deep as I would like. This one down here is actually a nice color. But, yeah, let me just... So these are some of the highlighters out of this Roxy Roxasaurus Contour and Highlight Palette. Nice little variation there. Very pretty. Not too bad. So yeah, most likely I would just use this dark one down here in the corner and use this dark contour for the most part. I'm not sure how this bronzer color would work for me. It looks a little bit gray. But it's a nice little palette, though. Very nice. Okay, next I have a go-to palette for me that never lets me down. This is my e.l.f. And this one is actually the Modern Metals. And it has highlighter and blush in here. I never go to it for blush for some reason, even though it has this gorgeous shade in here. But these up here are highlighters. And I really like... I use... I use this one up here a lot. So let me just swatch these three highlighters for you guys. And you guys know e.l.f. is like mad affordable, so this is what these highlighters look like. So they don't have that extreme shine you know, when you swatch them, but when you put them on your face, they look very, very nice. Very nice. And like I said, I always use this center one. It has a little bit of a peachy hue to it. Okay, next I have a highlighter in my Cover Effects palette. This is the Perfector Face Palette in Medium Deep. And I got this in my BoxyCharm. I actually switched it out with someone because they sent me the lighter one, I believe. And yeah, no, I need the deep one. But yeah, this is what this palette looks like. This palette is all around just bomb. I mean, from the bronzer to the blush to the highlighters, it's just, it is a bomb palette. And this is one of the best items that I've ever gotten out of my BoxyCharm, okay? I'm thankful I was able to switch with someone and get, you know, the tone that works for me. But yeah, everything in here is really nice, from the highlighters to the blush to the bronzer. It's really, really nice. I'll go ahead and swatch the bronzer and the blush for you guys as well, just in case you're curious. It's very, very nice for deeper skin tones. That blush color, oh, I love, love, love it. And you guys see that bronzer? Bomb. It's a contour. It's, you know, it's called a contour, but for me, I'll use it as a bronzer because it's not super cool tone. So this is definitely something that I would repurchase if I ever thought I was gonna run out of it, which I know I won't. Now this palette here, I just had to have it, okay? I was dying to have it. And now that I have it, I don't know what to do with it. I've watched videos on it. I've seen other people using it. But this is the Beauty Bakery Coffee and Cocoa palette. I mean, I just had to have this thing. And after I bought it, I was kind of like, what do I do with this? Because I don't like shimmer all over my face. I know it might be hard to tell because sometimes I'm just extra glowy depending on what setting spray I use. So you might actually think, oh, KK likes to be glowy. No, I really don't. So when there are products that have a lot of like sheen and shimmer to them, I don't know if you can see it, but this blush color is kind of sheeny. This bronzer is sheeny. You know, of course, this gorgeous highlight, I know what to do with that. But this is kind of like, I guess, a setting type or a finishing powder. It says Deja Brew, but I don't know. So it's like this palette is absolutely gorgeous, but I don't know. You know, this is too shimmery for me as a blush. This is way too shimmery as a contour. Only thing I can use out of here is the highlight. So it's like, even with as beautiful as these shades are, I'm more likely to use this as an eyeshadow palette than a face palette, just because I don't put shiny stuff all over my face. So as much as I, and this is the Deja Brew. Let me just show you that also, just in case you're curious about this whole palette. But that's the Deja Brew, so I would assume to use that kind of like a finishing powder just to complete the whole glowy look. But this palette is absolutely beautiful, and I don't know what to do with any of this except for the highlighter. So I just consider this a highlighter palette. If you guys have any suggestions as far as, you know, how I can get over the fact that everything is shimmery and just use it, I might do that one day in a video. I might just use it and just be like, you know what, let me just see how I look shining everywhere. I might like it. Who knows, right? Okay, so next here I have one from Ochre. Okay, I think, is this my only Ochre highlighter? This might be my only Ochre highlighter. This is the Everglow, and I think this was part of the Nikki Tutorials collab thing with them. I know I got this in a subscription box because I did not buy it, but these highlighters, y'all, Ochre highlighters, oh my goodness, to die for. Let me show you these colors on my skin tone, okay? Do you guys see that? Do you see those highlighters? Okay, from dark, medium to light. I mean, just gorgeous, absolutely beautiful. And inner corner highlight pop, face pop, all of that. This highlighter palette is definitely going to get more use in 2020. Okay, now this is a palette that I actually purchased a long time ago. I did a video using this and have not used it since. But I picked it up the other day and I was swatching it and I was like, girl, you need to use that palette. This is the BH Cosmetics Desert Oasis palette. And I know why I'm not necessarily drawn to it as an eyeshadow palette. As you can see, it's quite boring. But if you look at it in terms of like highlighters and, you know, there's even a nice little bronzer in here that I don't care about, you know, beautiful blue eyeshadow. But these highlighters, yo, let me swatch these for y'all. They are crazy. Do you guys see that? So, so pretty. And I know BH Cosmetics, you know, they just had a big sale. They're probably still having a sale, to be honest with you. And I'm pretty sure this was part of the sale. Let me swatch some of these eyeshadows just in case you're like thinking about getting this palette. But yo, this palette is worth purchasing, even if just for the highlighters. But the eyeshadows are gorgeous as well. You see that? So pretty. So yeah, I'm going to play around in this palette some more with these highlighters. I might even do another look with it. You know, ain't much I can do. Of course, I'm going to use that blue in an eye look. But, you know, you guys let me know if you want me to do another video with this palette. You know it's going to be a blue eye look. But yeah, definitely. I might even try out that bronzer too. It doesn't look like it's going to do much for me, but you know, why not? Okay, next year I have a palette that I purchased before Shop Hush went out of business. This is the Gold Dust palette. It's a quad of highlighters that was part of the Amber Shoal collection. I just depotted that palette because I really wanted to use those gold eyeshadows, so I needed to depot them. So I did depot the eyeshadow palette, but this is what the highlighter palette looks like. So it's nice. It's not anything to write home about just looking at it. It looks very blasé. But let me swatch it. Even though, from what I understand, to my understanding, you can't get it anymore. You know, somebody might be selling it on Poshmark or something like that if you are interested in it. But yeah, this was during the Shop Hush days, so you probably can't even get it anymore. But as you can see with these highlighters, there isn't really anything dark enough that I would just be drawn to. Not at all. I mean, all of these are very, very light. So this actually might be decluttered now that I'm looking at it, because there's nothing in here that I don't have in any of my other palettes, and they are all very, very light. So yeah, I actually think I'm going to end up decluttering this. Okay, next I have one that is a new favorite of mine. I just happened across this at the beauty supply store and I was like, what is that? Okay, this is my Kiss Glow and Bronze powder, and it's so funny because this is supposed to be a bronzer, and I'm like, who in the world is bronzing with this? Okay. Me and my girls was laughing about it. I was like, the tin man, I guess, honey, because that mug is shiny. You know, I would never bronze with anything this shiny, but I know a lot of people do use like shiny bronzers. Not your girl. But yo, as a highlighter, this thing is, it's ridiculous. It is ridiculous. It is so buttery smooth, and this color, as you can see, it just suits my skin tone perfectly. So when I put this on, it really does just give me that beautiful natural glow on my skin tone. Look at that. It's just, you just get that natural glow. Nothing crazy. I like it. I have the medium. I actually thought that I got the darkest one, but no, I got the medium. So very, very nice. Pick it up at your local beauty supply or on the Kiss website. I got mine for about $6 or $7, and I know that thing is going to last me forever, okay? Now, next, I have another duo here. This is a Color Rain and Power duo. It's the blush and highlighter duo. I got the shade My Day One, okay? Anybody that offers a deep, dark option, that's what I'm getting. But this blush is what really, really got me, okay? This blush is so pretty. And actually, if you don't want to buy this one, NYX has a blush that is a pretty good dupe for this color. Yeah, so the NYX Sweet Cheeks, and this one is Red Riot. It, to me, looks like almost a spot-on dupe. When you put it on, I mean, they are so close that you really can't tell the difference. I'm wearing the NYX one today, and I love it. It's such a pretty plummy shade. But anyway, we're not talking about blush. We're talking about highlights. But yeah, this duo is like one of my favorites right now. As you can see, I nicked it with my finger. I hate when I do that. I'm always, you know, when you're trying to be super careful and then you end up tearing something up while you're trying to be careful with it. But this is what this highlighter and blush duo looks like. And y'all, it is so pretty. I mean, for darker skin tone beauties, honey, you cannot go wrong with this. It's so pretty. And if you are on a budget and you don't, you know, want to pick that one up, go ahead and get this, honey. Get this and get this. And you will basically have the same stuff that's in that power duo right here, okay, for a budget. Now, you guys, I have just a few more that I want to talk about in my collection. I have the Anastasia Beverly Hills Amorizzi, okay? Packaging looks just like the bronzer packaging for Anastasia. But this is what the highlighter looks like. As you can see, I don't use it that much at all. I used to use it a lot when I first got it. It's really smooth, really silky, gorgeous, high quality. But it is a little bit icy. It is a little bit icy for me. Although it is super pretty, it is a bit light. So I don't use it that often. It's a very nice highlighter there, though. Very beautiful. So I don't know. I might end up giving that away one day. But because, yeah, I don't use it. Next, from my affordable highlighters, I have this Maybelline Master Chrome. Now, this highlighter is shabam, okay? This is what it looks like in the packaging. If you have not tried any of the Maybelline Master Chrome highlighters, I don't know what is going on, okay? Because these are really nice. I really like them. I go back and forth a lot of times with, look at that, whether or not I like these better or the Milani's better. It's kind of tough, but for a drugstore highlighter, okay, they are not playing. Look at that. That is so pretty. Oh my gosh, gorgeous. This would definitely be one of my top drugstore highlighters. I need to do my best of 2019 video, like my favorite products of 2019. Because I have some that are definitely favorites. Now, this here is probably going to get decluttered. This is something I got from RK Kiss. I'm sure I got it from my local drugstore a long time ago. This says All Over Glow Bronzing Powder. So it's another bronzer, another bronzing powder. But of course, if it's shiny, I'm going to use it for a highlighter. But I've had this for quite a while, and it seems like it's kind of gotten a little bit of hard pan or something. I don't even know if they sell this anymore. I've had it for so long, but oh, it still looks nice. Yeah, it still looks really pretty, actually. It's like a really subtle, soft glow. It doesn't have that super duper, like, the tip of my nose shine, okay? But it has a really nice, soft glow. I don't know. I might have to try this again before I declutter it, okay? Okay, next I have this Bronze Goddess highlighter. This one is in the shade Heat Wave. This is from Estee Lauder, okay? So it is a little bit pricey. It smells kind of perfumey. So if you don't like perfumey smelling makeup, you won't like this, but it is super pretty. This is like a very, very gorgeous bougie type highlighter. Let me go ahead and swatch this for you. This one, although it is gorgeous, it is very icy as well. So it's much lighter than what I would typically like to use as a highlighter. But depending on the eye look and what I'm going for, you know, this would definitely be like pow. So this is a very, very nice highlighter. Beautiful. Very, very nice. And I like having it in my collection. Next I have here from Becca. This is the Prosecco Pop. My champagne pop is like in a very small sample container that I think I got in one of my subscription boxes. But this is a larger one that I have that is Prosecco Pop. And I'm pretty sure I got this in a subscription box as well, because Lord knows I haven't bought any Becca highlighters. So this is what the Prosecco Pop looks like. So it's very pretty. It's kind of light as well. I definitely wear this. I definitely use it, would rock it. Yeah, it's very nice, and it creates a very nice smooth highlight. I like the Becca highlighters because when you blend them out, it's like they kind of just melt into your skin, you know. So even though it is a bit brighter than I would like, it does create a very beautiful highlight, and it just kind of melts into the skin. Okay, I have two more highlighter palettes in my collection. This one is from Lime Crime. It is their Blossoms or Highlight Blossoms highlighter palette. Very pretty packaging. It's like, you know, holographic. And this is what these highlighters look like. Very interesting colors. I always forget about this palette. I actually bought this at BeautyCon 2 years ago. Not the last BeautyCon, but the one before that. But these highlighters are really pretty, even though there are some very interesting shades. They're very, very pretty. As you can see, it's like a pinky one, kind of a lavender one, and some type of like duochrome situation going on here. So very pretty, really pretty. Actually, I really need to play around with these. That one is gorgeous. This one I think would just do a nice soft highlight for me. This has to be one of those days when I'm wilding out, okay? But yeah, it's a very pretty palette. I'm gonna have to put this to use. Okay, the last palette that I wanna talk about, this Revolution, this was their Vintage Lace palette, Intense Metallic Cream Powder Highlighters. I haven't had this that long, and I actually only used it once in a video with you guys. And it was kind of interesting because when I used it, you can see how it took off like the top layer of the highlighter in this one. So it's kind of like some kind of like top coat on here. And when you break through it, that glitter kind of goes away. It's weird. It's like they change colors as you swatch them and use them. They change colors. So let me show you what this looks like. So this is the Revolution Vintage Lace highlighter palette. But these are what those colors look like. They're really pretty if you're into like the different kind of holographic type shades or pastel type shades that kind of shift a bit. This is something that you might be into. They're very pretty. I would definitely use them. I mean, you know, the pink, the yellow, this kind of, what is that? Like a, I don't know what that is. It's like a pinky green, like a lavender green. And then this is kind of like a deeper, darker one. So yeah, I would definitely use these, but it would have to kind of depend on what I'm doing with my face that day. Some days I'm a little more adventurous, some days I'm not. So yeah, these would be on a more adventurous day for sure. Okay, so to finalize this highlighter swatching video, I have a few loose powder highlighters that I want to show you guys. And I also have just a couple of my liquid highlighters that I want to show you guys. Liquid highlighters actually scare me. That's why I never use them. A lot of people use these and then they put the powder on top and it really gives a beautiful glow and shine. I'm not that bold yet or that daring yet, but in the upcoming year, I want to try some new things. So I did go ahead and pull out some of my liquid highlighters to try out this year. Now for my loose powder highlighters, I have a couple here from ColourPop. These were part of Shayla's collection, I believe last year. This one is Pose and this one is Boomin. So let me go ahead and just swatch these for you guys. I don't even know if they're still selling these. I mean, they should, they're really pretty, but loose highlighters are kind of like, they're scary. They're a little scary because, you know, once you put highlighter on your face, if you go ham, it can be really hard to tone it down. So this first one is Pose. Well, this one is Pose and this one is Boomin. So, yeah. Let me just swatch, see if I can swatch. Oh, they feel so smooth. Oh my goodness. So I just took a little bit of that powder. As you can see, they feel really, really smooth though. Of course I used too much, but they feel really nice. They're really pretty. They don't have like that high beaming razzle dazzle effect to me, which I think is good for a loose powder, but the shades are really, really nice. I like Pose, I think, better than Boomin. Is it Boomin? Yeah, I like Pose better. It's just a nice, more warm tone for me. So, anyways, they look nice. I'm just not drawn to the loose powder highlighters. To me, they're just more trouble than they're worth. Like, what do you need a loose powder for? But anyways, I have some of these. And then I also have this one from Artist Couture. This is the Jackie Ina Le Bronze. I also bought her Le Peach that she came out with. I don't know where it's at though. But yeah, I do. I have the Le Peach as well. But this one is the Le Bronze. So let me swatch this, okay? Just in case you haven't seen it. Ooh, child. You see that? Do you see that Jackie Ina Le Bronze? Okay. Now, this loose highlighter is so pretty. I think I actually used this on my eyes once. I just did like a simple smoky eye. And then I placed some of this on my lid. And oh my gosh, it is so pretty, you guys. So there are a lot of different uses for loose highlighters, not just, you know, on your cheeks or whatever. You can definitely use these for like eyeshadow, inner corner pops, stuff like that. But yeah, this Le Bronze from Artist Couture, gorgeous. And lastly, let's take a look at these two liquid highlighters. This one is from Wet n Wild. It's one of their Hello Halo liquid highlighters. And it's called Go With The Glow. This teeny tiny baby writing. And this one has like a doe foot applicator, I believe. Yeah, it has like this giant doe foot applicator. And I don't know, I guess. But with the liquid highlighter, like I just put some of that down on my hand so you can see. But I don't know. For me, it's just really strange trying to put liquid highlighter over a powdered face. Like, you know, because I do my highlighter like last when it comes to my face and stuff. But you can see how pretty that looks. It is so gorgeous. I'm just always afraid of it moving my powder around, but honey, I'm gonna try it out because it is so pretty. So, so gorgeous. And lastly, I have one here from Delancey. I purchased these off of Amazon. I did a whole video when Fenty came out with her, you know, body glow stuff. I did a whole video looking for dupes. So This was like part of my dupe video where I was just trying to find dupes for that stuff because I was like, I am not paying for that stuff. Now this one has like a little dropper, if you can see that. Yeah, it has like a little dropper situation, but honestly, I don't feel like you need that because you're only going to just use a tiny bit. Like, see, I just wiped a little bit of that on my hand. Now this one here has some serious beaming going on, so I'm just trying to blend it out some so you can see how the liquid highlighters kind of look on your skin. But you can see how pretty that would look on the face. It is so pretty. Oh my gosh, it's gorgeous. And this Delancey one, I'm sure, was pretty inexpensive on Amazon when I bought it. I know Delancey has their own website because they have their own products and stuff, so who knows what other colors they might have available now. But yeah, these liquid highlighters, I'm going to have to start using them, you guys, because I've purchased so much stuff in my collection that is just sitting, basically going bad, that I could really be styling and profiling with, okay? So anyways, those are not all of my highlighters, but that's enough for today. Just to give you an idea of why I'm going to really try to stop purchasing highlighters, okay? So yeah, I will be doing more Shop My Stashes, more using my products, more trying my makeup stuff. So yeah, you're going to see a lot more of these highlighters as well as other makeup that I have that just is getting neglected. Okay, so that's it for this video, you guys. Thank you so much for hanging out with me for this long, and I will see you on my next video. Don't forget to hit like on your way out. If you're not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe to your girl, and I will see you on the next one. Toodles!